We will start our problem with a square. Then, inside this square, we will put another square so that its left side is touching the left side of our bigger square. Then, we will connect the top right corners of our two squares, and we will do the same for the bottom right corners. And in this way, we have formed four areas inside the big square. So, if the upper segment has the area of 7 and the bottom segment has the area of 3, is it somehow possible for us to find the area of the red segment on the right? If you want to try to solve this interesting problem for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So, I'm going to offer you two different methods to solve this awesome problem. The first method will use the trapezium to solve the problem. So, we're going to start by labeling the red area as A. Then, we will notice that this red area actually represents a trapezium. So, let's just remind ourselves that if we have a trapezium with the bases of A and B and the height of H, this means that the area of the trapezium will be equal to the half of the sum of the bases times the height. Now, if we take a look at our sketch, we can label the side of our big square as A and the side of our small square as B. Those two sides will actually represent the bases of our red trapezium. Now, let's try to find the height of this trapezium. We can do this by first label the horizontal side of the big square as A and the small square as B again. Then, we can clear our image a little bit and rearrange the sides. Now you can see that the blue line, which represents the height of our trapezium, must be equal to the difference between the lengths of two sides of our squares. Now we can say that the red area of our trapezium is equal to the a plus b over 2 times the height, which is equal to a minus b. Alright, so now let's set our attention to the area on the top. This area on the top is also a trapezium, but it is right trapezium. So we already know that its bases are equal to A and B, so all that we are missing is its height. Since we do not know it, we're going to label it as X. Now we can say that this green area is equal to A plus B over 2 times X, and since we know that this area is equal to 7, we can just replace its area with 7. Now, we can do the same thing for the area on the bottom. You can see that this area is also a right trapezium, and it also has the bases of A and B. Now, let's try to find its height. We can easily do this by first clearing up our image a little bit and rearrange the lines. Now you can see that this small segment is equal to the side of the big square minus side of the small square minus the height of our trapezium on the top. Alright, so now we can say that this blue area is equal to a plus b over 2 times the height, which is equal to the quantity of a minus b minus x. And since we know that this area is equal to 3, we can just substitute this value. Now, let's take a look at those two equations. We can now add those two equations together, and if we do this, we will get the following. Now we can simplify this equation. We can first notice that we have the common factor on the right, and if we isolate it in front of the brackets, we will get the following. Now we can cancel plus and minus x, and if we do this, we will get that 10 is equal to a plus b over 2 times a minus b. Now, let's compare this to our previous equation for the red area. You can see that the right side of those two equations are actually identical. So, this leads us to conclude that our red area is actually equal to 10 squared units, and this is our solution. Alright, so now let me show you the second method, which is actually my favorite one, and it will use the limit case. For this method, let's first label the red area as A again. Then, for the better understanding, I will clone this image and put it to the right, so that you can see what's happening. Now, let's consider the limit case, in which we will slide down our small square to the bottom of the big square. And if we do this, we will push the bottom area to the top. So, the top will be equal to the sum of the top and the bottom areas. But, if you're wondering why is this possible and how is this possible, well, of course, I will show you. Let's first label the sides of the big square as A and the small square as B, just as we did before. Then, let's label the height of the trapezium on the top as H1 and the height of the trapezium at the bottom as H2. Now, we already know that this area of the top is equal to 7, and since it is trapezium, it will be equal to the sum of the bases over 2 times the height h1. The same thing applies for the trapezium on the bottom, and its area is equal to 3, and its height is h2. Now, let's add those two areas together. If we do this, we will get that 10 is equal to a plus b over 2, times the sum of those two heights. And you can notice that the height of our big square is equal to the height of the small square plus those two heights. So, what happens if we slide down our square? Well, if we do that, you can see that the length of those two heights will be translated to the top. Again, we will have the same situation. We have the heights h1 and h2 plus the height of the small square, which is equal to the height of the big square. So, as you can see, we have another trapezium on the top, and the area of this trapezium is again a plus b over 2 times the sum of the heights h1 and h2. This, of course, means that this area on the top is equal to 10, and since we have the small square on the bottom corner of the big square, the symmetry applies, which means that the area on the top is actually equal to our wanted red area on the right. So, in this way, we know that our wanted red area is equal to 10 squared units, and this is our solution. I personally love this problem, and I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. If you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or consider subscribing to the channel for more content like this in the future. And if you have another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section. And as always, until next time, see you all and take care.